Why should we, African women, settle for equality when we have had divinity? You know, I'm talking about, for example, today, where is the female imam? Where is the female rabbi? Where is the female pope? Those people do not exist. These other societies out of Africa have disrespected their women for so long. But in Africa, in ancient Africa, our women were so respected. Our women were divinities. They were deities. They were queens. They were queen mothers. They were prime ministers. This whole idea of these recent leaders being the first head of state is not real, because we have had heads of state as women since ancient times, you know? And the whole concept of justice and balance and truth is represented by a woman, Maat. And Maat is the deity that represents truth, balance, and law. And when you think about Maat in Kinyarwanda, is Amateka, Amategeko, a society which is ruled by laws. And those laws govern the entire society, and they do not discriminate between men and women. Our women have always been honored. I'm so happy that I was born a Rwandan woman. If you're going to be born on this planet and be honored as a woman, you need to be born in Africa, because that's really the place where women have always had great positions, have always been in power. And women were never enslaved or under the men until Africa got invaded. This is something that we need to take into consideration.